And I've had people ask, well, when are you guys going to put a best of record out?
The Greatest Hits started as, it was interesting, the process. I mean, the emotion that went into figuring out what songs need to be on there.
You know, nothing is really happens without the orchestration of God behind it.
It's finally coming, it's finally here, it's coming out, and I'm excited about it. Just between you and me, I've got something to say.
Singing live is wonderful because when you've got an audience, it's different when you're in a studio, because when you're in a studio, you have to be inspired by memory or inspired by the words, or you have to actually think of things that inspire you when you're creating. But when you're live in front of people, inspiration is found in the faces of people and the different cities that you're in. I wanna be in the light, as you are in the light. I wanna shine like stars in the heavens. Oh Lord, be my light and be my salvation. Cause all I want is to be in the light. All I want is to be in the light.
The Erase Foundation for DC Talk was as natural as breathing. Eliminating racism and creating equality.
Living integrated, it's so obvious.
Toby, Kevin, and myself, we are living integration.
You know, it's just, it's every day, it's the way it is. Colors don't hate. What blows my mind is when I travel around the United States and you find people that don't get that.
We think because we don't see it maybe right out today and we think that it's gone. But it's very much alive, very much so in America. And we'd be naive and even more ignorant to think that it's actually gone.
The Erase Foundation was sort of the next step to do something tangible. We take the term Jesus freak and it means an ardent enthusiast, someone that is enthusiastic about Jesus. This book sort of takes it to a new level.
It's kind of like a modern day version of the Fox's Book of Martyrs.
I've always wanted to be a part of something like that, where it's talking about actual people that have been persecuted for their faith and actually are martyrs.
These are the ultimate Jesus freaks, people that died because of their faith in Christ.
If you like DC Talk or don't like DC Talk, it doesn't matter. It stands on its own.
It's not about us. It's using our platform to shed light on some people that deserve a spotlight, people that are being persecuted in the name of Jesus or have been, and people that have been murdered.
It's a great book. It's just a great piece of history.
Those people had to die for their faith, and all we really have to do is live for ours. What will people think when they hear that I'm a Jesus freak? What will people do when they find out it's true? Oh, I don't really care if they label me a Jesus freak. There ain't no disguising the truth. Hey, oh, hey, oh, hey. Ladies and gentlemen,
the Reverend Dr. Billy.
You know, we've been privileged to be a part and really been blessed to be a part of the Billy Graham Crusades.
To walk into a stadium and see and watch a simple man share a simple message and people come forward in the droves. I mean, it's unbelievable.
To be able to do 13 or 14 Graham Crusades is amazing. I mean, it makes everything we do worth doing.